do modified push-ups or go up at a higher level surface for doing these multiple times like we are, okay? Multiple times during the week anyway. So go ahead and let's get started on warm-up. I want you to step forward, keeping that back leg straight, and we're gonna push down into it and then come back up. So the front knee is bending, and then you're pushing back up through that foot, getting this hip opener here. I don't have my water out here with me right at the moment, but make sure you have water so that you can grab a sip whenever we're taking breaks. We're going to be doing timed exercises. Okay, I want you to step forward, step that other leg back, straight leg. I'm going to go a little bit at an angle with you and bend that front knee. Push back up. Sorry for my dog hacking if you heard that. Doing hip openers because anytime you are sitting, we are shortening the hip flexor muscles and then they are contracted, right? So we want to open up the front side of our body as much as possible. All right, step together. So we're gonna do a knee hug and go to the other side. You can step side to side. Walk forward, you can stay in place. And release. So what I want you to do here and what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk out to my step here and then I'm going to do a push-up. So start out with me. You're gonna bend those knees slightly, go down to the floor, walk it out, hands on that incline, or you can come down on your knees if you're on the floor. We're going to push up here, then walk back, stand up, then come down again. Anytime you're doing push-ups, what I want you to remember is get an inhale, exhale as you come back up, because that exhale is going to help you contract your core and use your core helping you to come back up. Okay, go ahead and release there. So we're going to start out with our weight doing single leg deadlifts, and we have 60 seconds. Basically, you should be able to perform 20 to 30 of these in that 60 seconds, just to give you a little bit of an estimate. Depends on how much you're having to slow down to concentrate on your form and your balance, okay? So if you need a chair to hold on to, single leg, stationary leg is slightly bent, take that leg back, keeping it nice and flat back. You want to look in the same direction that your chest is going the entire time. You can do these without a weight to begin with if you need to. And if you feel like your back starts to round, like here, and you start to fall down and round to get further, you want to stop at that point and then come all the way back up, okay? And I'm on an uneven surface being outside. My grass obviously has dips and stuff, and so that challenges my balance even more, with my ankles having to work to try to stabilize me. Feel that in the back side of the leg. We're working the hamstrings and the glutes and the calf muscles ahead and come on up. We're gonna take a little slight break as we adjust and go to the other side. So slight bend in that knee. Take that leg back, keeping the hips square to the floor. So some people, when they lose balance, start to open up the hips to try to compensate. So you want to try to keep those hips in alignment and staying in that starting position the entire time. I did 15. So, you know, roughly everybody's going to be different as far as how many reps they can fit in that 60-second interval. Now, we're going to do T push-ups. I'm going to show you in a standard push-up, but you can do this modified by knees down, push-up, rotate to the side and come up like that. And then you will push up and you will go the other way. Okay, you guys ready? We have 60 seconds here. Push up, nice deep breath. Exhale, rotate, side plank, come up. As you get the form, you'll be better at doing it a little bit quicker. Focusing on your breathing, readjust as needed. Again, making sure that your hips are square. Coming all the way back up, nice and tall. Sometimes we want to cheat and just stop halfway up. Have about 5 more seconds and release here. All right. We're going to set up for the other leg here. So I want you to take that leg back. Hips are forward. You keep that straight spine. Taking it back, you can do a little pelvic tilt right here, tuck, to try to help not have an exaggerated arch in your lumbar spine. Keep those shoulder blades back. don't think I've said that this video yet. Scoot back into your chair. We're going to get a quick little rest. Go ahead and grab your band. Okay, so we're going to do clams. I want you to do 15 seconds. Actually, we're going to do 20 seconds on one side, 20 seconds on the other side. So be ready to switch sides quickly. Feet stay stacked, hips are stacked, knees open. Squeeze the booty, open up, feel that resistance. Try not to let that bottom leg lift up, and also try not to roll back. So keep those hips stacked. Okay, be ready to switch directions. I'm scooting, I'm trying. Okay, so open and close. Feel that resistance in the booty. If it helps, you can squeeze that glute, then open. Also 45 seconds. You guys get in position. at a higher level surface if we need to. Knee comes to opposite elbow. Keep that head up in that chin retraction. Try not to round out your back. Keep those shoulder blades retracted. You guys, 10 more seconds here. If your low back starts to hurt you, I need you to pause for a second. Walk it in. I need you to pause for a second if you start to feel your low back start to engage, okay? We're gonna go into dips again. Ready? Getting my time. All right, set up. Drop it down. Keep that breathing going. Try not to let yourself scoot too far away from your chair, so stay close. Guys. All right, we're going into those clams. So during your rest, you're getting this band on. All right. On your elbow, hips in line with the shoulders, feet are stacked. Open up. Breathing so you also have your core contracted as well as working your booty. And release. All right, let's get that band off as we transition to that crossbody mountain climber. All right, you guys ready? Down in that mountain climber position, knee towards the opposite elbow, keeping your head up. Again, you can go to a higher level surface. Go to your kitchen table. Use a chair, whatever you have. If you need to modify, if your back hurts, we have 5 seconds here. And walk it in. One more round. One more round. Okay, so taking a quick little breather. All right. Let's hit it back into dips here. So get yourself situated and slide off and drop it down. Keep that breathing going. Taking it back, feeling it in the backs of those arms. Here. right into it. Open up. Squeeze the booty. Open those knees. Keep those feet stacked. Keep yourself from rolling back. Lifted up higher to lower down, but I'm still working those muscles just as much. So you can be up here if that's more comfortable for you, or you can rest down on your elbow. Just focus on feeling that squeeze. You can do this without the band. But this just helps add more resistance if you're having a hard time actually feeling those muscles engage without the band. Okay, coming up, remove your band. Let's go into that mountain climber cross body, and we're coming down. My time here, and we're going to go ahead and start cross knee to elbow. Because I injured my foot and I don't want to make it hurt anymore. Ready? Jack it out. You can speed it up or even go slower. Control that movement. Whatever fits your current fitness level, okay? You guys, this is just to get your heart rate up. Bring it in. Okay. Slight little breather. So what we're going to do here is you're going to take this leg back and bring that knee up and do a little hop. And if you need to, you just take it back and bring the knee up without the hop at all. All right. Ready? Step it back. Knee up. Work those arms into it. engagement. Step that back leg, pushing the heel down. All right, we're switching legs. I want you to go right into it. That other leg was kind of getting a little bit of a rest. Ready? Pop it forward, step back. Work those arms. This is just like a walk or a run motion. And release. Okay, so we're gonna do some squat jumps here. I'm gonna show you modified. First, you're simply just gonna sit back into that squat and come up. Modify for 30 seconds. All right, you guys, ready? Join me. Squat and come up, or add a hop, okay? I can do this one a little bit better with that injured toe because my feet are pretty much staying flat and I'm flexing at the ankles, and it doesn't involve any kind of motion out to the side or flexion of my toes so much. And release here. All right, we're gonna walk it out. You're gonna grab a sip of water for me. Okay, I want you to go legs wide, and I want you to take those arms up. We're gonna take the hip out to the side, going down to the outside foot, opposite to the other foot, and bring it up. Take it back down from the foot you came up from, going to the side and bringing it up. We're gonna do that a couple more times. Nice, fluid motion. Back of the legs are getting stretched. Lower back is getting stretched. QLs are getting stretched. Your shoulders are in it. All right. We're working on everything here. Last time over, I want you to come to center. Walk those feet in. Take the feet back a little bit. Push the heel down. Bend the other knee. Turn to the side some, and then switch legs. Push that heel back. Feel the back side of the leg. Feel the calf muscles. It's like you're pedaling here in down dog position. Slowing down the breath. My watch says 232 calories burned for this workout, right at 30 minutes. All right, you guys, you did amazing. Let me know what you think in the Facebook group, and let me know how you're doing.